Welcome to the interview series at CSTEP. Today we have with us Mr. Ravi Lepakshi. He is the advisor for the smart grid projects at CSTEP. Mr. Lepakshi has several years of experience, professional experience at KPTCL and BESCOM. Primarily, his areas of interest are distribution automation systems, cables and smart grid. Thank you, Mr. Lepakshi, to be in this interview. So I would like to start with, what is smart grid and why this technology is important for India?
Smart grid is modernized technology, modernized electric grid, which gathers information, because from analog to digital information, it acts on the information to know the communication technology, knows the behavior of the supplier and the customers, and takes the information to improve in automatic fashion to improve the, we know the conditions of the suppliers and the consumers, and to know the product for the production of distribution and supply of electricity.
Okay.
And there are different definitions on this one. Why this technology is very important in India? Because in India, though India is the third largest grid in India and the fourth largest in the world in the network, but unfortunately the huge losses, and there are about 3.4 crores households were yet to see the power, and Government of India in the previous regime had promised power to all by 2012, but unfortunately that could not take place. Now the new government has extended up to 2019, and the financial losses is around about 3.5 crores of losses being by the incurring by the utilities in India. So the reason for this technology is so important because of the high distribution losses, and there is a shortage of power, whether it is peak or energy shortages are there, and a poor reliability of supply, and consumer has not been access to the theft. A lot of theft is taking place, which the utilities are not able to curb the technology. When smart grid technology comes into the picture, all these elements could be avoided and can give power to all, and also reliable power to the consumer at affordable cost. That is why this technology is very important in India.
Okay, nice to know. So according to you, what is the current smart grid capability in India and Karnataka in particular?
Yeah. In India or Karnataka, the smart grid technology is a new technology in India. So only the pilots have been studied. The communication part and the hardware and software technology has not been proved still today. And especially in India, only one of the government of India, they formed the smart grid task force, and the smart grid forum has also been formed. And those with the help of government of India under the Ministry of Power, they have been given these funds to, for the 14 states, pilot has to be studied. So for all the 14 pilots, none of the pilots have been implemented. It is all on the nascent stages. Some are issued the orders, some are still on the issue of the tenders, etc. The communication technology has not been tried. So in Karnataka also, CES company under the Government of India, Ministry of Power, the company of CES has been awarded to go for the smart grid. They have taken up the smart grid projection. They have given an order to a private firm with PSGCL as the consultant for that firm. When we look back in Karnataka, way back in 2010, BESCOM was the first state in India to introduce the smart grid in a large way. And CPRA had done the initial project report for BESCOM. Then under the USTDA funding, KEMA was awarded to study the report and how to go about this project, and the they had to suggest the technology and the hardware, software, etc. and identify. Electronic City was suggested to go there, but unfortunately KEMA under the various management till the last, they had not completed the project report. Hence, that project could not be still taken up, still it is in the storage. Then BESCOM wanted to go ahead after this 14 project, but Bangalore City was not identified as this project. Then BESCOM, under the guidance of PGCL, they took up the Indiranagar subdivision as one section for 20,000 consumers where you have a mix of all consumers. So they got me to do that, and they wanted to get an exemption under 3G under Government of India under the Ministry of Finance. But that is still, it has taken some 8-9 months, we could not do that. I'm told that is government of Karnataka is clear, and if that comes true, there is about 20 crores will be invested in Indranagar project to have various applications of smart grid. So this is what has happened in Karnataka and India in particular.
Okay. So moving on to my next question. What are the main challenges that we need to address to set up smart grids, both at the national and state levels?
Yeah, it's a very good question you asked me. Today, the smart grid technology is a new technology, as told. The operating cost and inception, the production cost of installing a smart grid itself is very high. And that is the most important. The next important thing is the technology is nothing, no technology has been proven today. So the technology part is very important because you cannot compare India with other countries. So the technology available in India, so that technology which, like example, the hardware and the software and the computer, the communication technology, this is the biggest challenge for us. Then the another important thing is the financial investment for this project, and where will the project will get such a huge amount for investing, because as I told you, the operating cost is so high and the fixed charges are coming, and who is going to fund? As I said, there is 3.5 lakh crores losses in the financial losses for the utilities, and where does the fund come from, and how this fund can, the payback period can be satisfied by investors. Suppose you invest 100 crores, how long you take to invest, and what should be your distribution losses reducing, how the company should be viable, that is one thing. And the regulator is one of the issues. The regulatory frameworks for this type of project, the regulator and the consumer should cooperate for duty. And what is the incentives that is going to give us for the regulator? And the regulator should insist with the consumers and the utilities to go in for this technology to save the energy. Like conservation of energy, so much of energy is wasted either way, if rampant theft or commercial losses. So this technology is very important, and the regulatory framework should be such a way there must be some incentive to the consumer, incentive to the utilities. The other point is the consumer is not aware of this. What is the benefit I get? So consumer awareness should be a big mass program for the entire consumers, the usefulness of this, yes, because even in US or in India today, the consumer wants his privacy. And they say health hazards are also there by using the smart grid because of the radio activities and communication that is taking place in smart grid. So consumer awareness is very important. The other challenge we have is the technology, the skills that is required to implement this one. So the utility engineers or workers, they are not trained about the new technology. So the training program to see this technology is updated and implementation says so that there is no pitfalls while doing the operation of the implementation. So high skills and training is required for the employees. I feel these are the major challenges in front of us to implement smart grid in India or in Karnataka. It is same whether or more in India. So this is my question.
So moving on to my next question, could you share some highlights of CSTEP's current smart grid project?
Yeah, this is also a question where the CSTEP, that's what I said, in BESCOM, this was the third project which took up under the DST. So here, this technology, in fact, in the beginning stage, it was to do at Rajajinagar in Bangalore city. This is a design and develop a smart grid architecture.
Right.
Here, again, designing, evolving communication and meters.
Okay.
So this, we thought of doing it in Bangalore, in Rajajinagar. To some sequences, etc., the BESCOM has not agreed to do it in BESCOM. They wanted to do it in a rural area at Chandapuram. So if you have done at Bangalore city, this 11 kV automation, distribution automation was in place. So this smart could have been an added feature for that. So this could have been done. Unfortunately, in the rural areas, there is no distribution automation. So now CSTEP has taken this project. The MOU is already signed between BESCOM and IHU, BHU, IIT, Banaras, yeah, who are the leader, and CSTEP would be implementing it under the guidance. So here, the main thing we are doing is we are introducing this AMI architecture, advanced meter infrastructure, wherein the smart meters will be installed for domestic, commercial, and HT industries. Here, the implementation, and one more thing is, we will be using this peak load management and outage management. Peak load and outage management, only thing is, we will be informing the consumers with the data available. This is an outage for you, and this is the time it may take. That is one. This automatic meter reading, where we are using a smart grid, wherein we will have two ways of communication. One, through the communication through the data center, the information we flow in. We will be knowing the current usage of the each consumer at each node.
Okay.
So theft, etc. can be easily identified.
Okay.
And the billing efficiency will improve. Because in Tesla, what in my own experience, the 100% billing is not being done. So by doing the smart grid, you are reading the meter 100%. Okay. And the bills will be 100% issue. So the billing and collection efficiency will be 7%. Then we will be knowing who are the people who are doing the theft.
Mm.
And the meter is not working. And remotely you can see the where the meter sub-meter is, faulty meters can be identified.
Okay.
And one more, the applications here in CSTEP is also the drawer. Suppose the sanctioned load is about 3 kilowatts. If the consumer is using 4 kilowatts, we will be knowing through the smart meter that 1 kilowatt extra is there. We will serve a notice to the consumer to get a sanction the another 1 kilowatt. Where the fixed charges will be automatically coming to the utility, where the increase in the collection efficiency.
Okay.
And also, when we are knowing at each node what is the current used by the consumer, at that point of time what we are going to use it, this we will be knowing the energy audit, we can say what is the consumption, what is from which transformer the supply is coming in, what is the input and what is the output. So even the study can be made and doing analysis of the loads. So these are the benefits smart system for when it is implemented. It will be very successful. We hope the smart grid in BESCOM, before smart grid of taking place of this KEMA, BESCOM KEMA, this I think so would be the first.
Okay.
So this is what I would like to say, share my experience with the system and the smart grid.
Thank you very much, Mr. Ravi Lepakshi. If you want to know more about our smart grid work, you can either send an email to cpe@cstep.in or visit our website www.cstep.in.